Sarah Stewart, and I will be presenting my research for Mississippi University for Women on is co-teaching effective in the middle school and at the middle school level. I'm a sixth grade teacher at Wetumpka Middle School, and I teach with 11 special ed students in my classroom, in a classroom of 24. Okay, first of all, let's talk about what is co-teaching. Co-teaching is a form of shared ownership in the classroom. They share in the duties of the classroom, and there are different types of models. So the co-teaching models are over here. We have one teach, one assist, which is where you have the general education teacher and the special education teacher in the same room, where one is actually doing the instructing while another is assisting, just walking around and dealing with behavior issues or dealing with issues that come up within the curriculum. You have one teach, one observe, which is where one teacher, either the general education teacher or the special education teacher, is actually presenting the information while the other is simply observing either at a desk or at some point or some place in the classroom. And they are strictly collecting data at that time. You have parallel, which is the same information being presented to half the group in one room and half the group in another room, and you have the same goal. Then you have teaming, which is where you have special ed and general ed teachers in the same room, bouncing back and forth between each other to present the information. And then you have stations, which is the co-teaching language for center. So you have different stations set up around your room where you have five or six students in each station. You have independent stations, and then you have stations where the general education teacher is at one and the special education teacher is at another. Say the problem statement for this research: teachers see co-teaching is not successful in the middle school setting and just another duty to add to their already overloaded plate. So we know as teachers that we have a lot of duties that we have to continuously check off of a list, it seems like. So to most teachers at this level, with the caseload that they have and the amount of students that they have, they feel like co-teaching is just another thing that they have to do. They don't see the benefits of it. So my statement of purpose: the purpose of this study is to show general education teachers the benefits of co-teaching on classroom disruptions, behavior issues, and success on standardized testing and overall grades in the middle school setting. So the descriptions of the people who are participating in this study: our community is Wetumpka, Alabama. We're located in the River region of Alabama. We are an urban setting. The setting of the actual study was a sixth grade co-taught classroom at Wetumpka Middle School. We have about 1,100 students at our school and about 300 in sixth grade. Our diversity is we have about 64% white students, we have 30% African American and 6% other, and then we are 90% free and reduced lunch. The participants in my study were 53 sixth grade students and three teachers. Two being general education, one being special education, one teacher who is actually not in co-teaching, which is Amanda Killo, and then myself and then Ms. Carpenter, who is my special education co-teacher. The author's role is myself. I'm the sixth grade co-teacher. So for my literature review, I read 10 different articles that all had the same common ground of, first of all, what is co-teaching? Why is it important and how is it successful? So they all basically said the exact same thing, that it's all about the presentation to the teachers. So if teachers know what's expected and they know how to implement it and are given adequate professional development, they feel like it is very beneficial to them in the classroom. They feel that those that feel like they don't understand what's going on is because they haven't been adequately trained, and data supports it. We've had huge successes here, but even the literature reviews that I've read, the data totally backs up what we are saying as our problem statement. So our description: the problem discussed in this research proposal is the effectiveness of co-teaching. So note the problem is most teachers feel like it's just another thing to check off their list. So my role in this was to get them to see the effectiveness of it through data. So my documentation: these are the different problems that teachers feel like is going on, and then I have solutions throughout. to have problem. Teachers feel as though co-teaching is another task to check off an already overflowing list. Special education students are still serviced without co-teaching. That's one argument that teachers say. If special education teacher is doing her job and I'm doing my job, why do I need to go through the steps of co-teaching? And this happens with a special education checklist. Teachers can monitor 25 to 30 students themselves. That can be accomplished through the behavior management sheet. Special education teachers cannot teach the content as well as general education teachers. This is noted by teacher certifications. Teachers are given classrooms with the necessary tools to take care of the instruction. This is proven by the inventory sheets. So these are all the different problems and how general education teachers are telling me, I can do all this and here's my proof without co-teaching. So my proposed solution to all of the different problems or responses that they have, the proposed solution is to train general and special education teachers in the art of co-teaching. This goes through teach, model, and feedback. We teach them exactly what it is through the different models, through professional development. We model it, as in some people come into my actual classroom and see how it is, and then they give feedback on how does it work, what's working, how do you do this in your classroom, how can I modify it to work in my classroom, and then actual co-teachers need to go see it be done and give them feedback as well. This can be accomplished through instructional rounds as well, where you have teachers come observe that have no idea what co-teaching is and let them just see how it's implemented and give them give me feedback on how it's working in my classroom so that I can better serve my students and the students of our school as a whole. Say the research design. So the site, as I mentioned earlier, is Wetumpka Middle School, and the participants was my classroom. Both, I have two. So I have my co-talk classroom, and then I have my general education classroom that is not serviced by the special education teacher through co-teaching. So here are my data collection tools. We have five. So we have a teacher survey, which was with Ms. Killo, who is a seventh grade social studies teacher with no co-teaching experience. We have an artifact of the grades of my students on a graph. We have a teacher survey of Ms. Carpenter, who has been a co-teacher for 2 years. We have an observation, which is the Alabama State Department's observation of a co-talk classroom's effectiveness. And then we have a survey of students who are actually in the co-talk classroom and how they feel it works, because at the end of the day, that's what we really want to know. How do the students feel about it? And do they feel like they're being serviced and getting the best instruction possible? So here's my data table. So I have two students right here. We have PH, TC. These are in the co-talk classroom. And as you can see on the graph, one has an 88 overall average and the other has an 82 overall average. This is for the second semester in English Language Arts. And then we have two special education students, MH and ZR, who are in the non-co-talk classroom, getting serviced by special education but not through the co-talk model, and they have a 74 and a 72. So there's a little bit of data showing the difference in the same material being taught but the delivery methods being a little different and the success of it. Here we have another data table. This is an Alabama Department of Education checklist from a actual observation that was taking place during a classroom setting on September 28th. So you can see throughout all these check marks are the different things that were happening. We have teacher to student feedback, we have great movement throughout, we have chant lessons, we have objectives being met, clear directions, and we have no disruptions, which is huge in a sixth grade classroom with 24 students. So we also gave a co-teaching survey to Ms. Killo, and the questions were things like, do you feel like you've been adequately trained on co-teaching? Which of course she responded no, because no professional development has been offered. The other questions were, do you think that students could be successful in this and why? And she responded, of course they could be successful. How could it not work when you have another adult in the classroom to help monitor the disruptions and to help your special education and general education students when they're not getting what they need from you as one person? You have another support system there. Then we also gave the same survey to Ms. Carpenter, who is our co-teacher in special education, and she said, of course, to the same questions, that she felt like students were getting the information better and clearer. There were less disruptions, and students were meeting the standards a lot more quickly because of the two of us in one classroom. Then we have the classroom survey. I have 24 students, and out of the 24, 20 believe that they have learned a lot better through co-teaching. And they all say, out of the 20, they say that they feel like they have more opportunities to respond. They feel like when we break off into the different models, such as station and parallel, that they aren't as embarrassed to respond. My special education students have a level of confidence that they didn't have to begin with, because now they're getting more familiar and more competent in the information, so they're a lot more likely to respond when asked a question. And their averages as a whole are drastically improving, so they're very, very welcoming of the experience. So what are the outcomes? We have our research, we have our data and what it says, but what do we hope to accomplish through this research? So short term, we hope that the interactions with students, we hope that that increases, because when I have less students to interact with, I can be, number one, more positive, and I can be a lot more zoned in with that student or that group of students on what they actually need from me. It can be a lot more differentiated that way. And we have long term, we'll have better engagement, less students or more teachers in the room is going to cut down on your disruptions, huge. It's going to make it a lot more close-knit community in your classroom. You're going to have that climate of respect and engagement throughout. And your test results are going to go up. This has to happen because you're able to actually hone in on skills with your students because you have either half the class or you have smaller groups, so your students are asking better and more questions. You're able to answer those questions, and you're able to completely shift your thinking and shift your instructions to meet the different needs of your learners. So my conclusion is co-teaching is a way of meeting the needs of many learners while helping monitor behavior issues as well. If co-teaching is done effectively, you're going to have better test scores because, like I mentioned a second ago, you're going to have the opportunity to actually meet the needs of every learner because you have smaller groups, so you have less time for the off-task behavior, so you're going to be able to accomplish a lot more, so you're not going to have to constantly say sit down or constantly be quiet or anything like that because you have less interruptions because they're engaged completely in your lesson.